Hi friends, in this video I am going to explain about the agarose gel electrophoresis and materials required for this method. Now let us see the materials required to prepare the agarose gel. We need the materials as agarose, 1x TAE buffer, nucleic acid stain. Here we can use either ethidium bromide or any other lab safe nucleic acid stains. It is generally recommended to use the lab safe nucleic acid stain as ethidium bromide is carcinogenic and everybody know that. So better to go for other lab safe nucleic acid stains. And loading time, a DNA ladder which will be available in different sizes like 50 base pair, 100 base pair, 1 kb, 1 kb plus. According to size of the PCR amplified product, we have to choose the DNA ladder. Then amplified PCR products along with positive and negative control. Positive is the which is already known control, and negative is the generally we will use healthy, which do not give any amplification or without adding any template. And measuring spatula, weighing boards, conical flask, weighing balance, measuring cylinder, microwave oven for heating the gel, and gel casting tray with comb and rubber grip. Here you can see the pictures of all the required materials like agarose, measuring spatula, weighing board, conical flask. For preparing 100 ml, that is 1% of agarose gel, you have to take 250 ml conical flask, weighing balance and amplified PCR product, DNA ladder and DNA loading die and nucleic acid stain. To pour the gel, you require a gel casting tray and a comb for loading the PCR samples. You have to insert the comb in the gel and gel electrophoresis unit along with the power supply and rubber grip to touch the hot surfaces. Now let us see the exact method how to prepare the gel. Here I am mentioning about the 1% agarose gel. For 1% agarose gel, you have to weigh the 1 gram of agarose with a spatula in a weighing board with the help of weighing balance. After measuring, here just I show the picture for giving an idea. So 1 gram means it is very like a pinch, very less amount. And after measuring, you pour the agarose powder into 250 ml conical flask. For preparing the 1% agarose gel, you have to take the 250 ml conical flask. After pouring, add the 100 ml of 1x TAE buffer. After adding the TAE buffer, boil this conical flask, that is the boiling of the solution, for 2 minutes with intermittent mixing so that any clumps will not form in the flask. After boiling, remove the flask from the oven with the help of heat grip and allow to cool at the room temperature. After cooling, just add the 4 to 5 microliter of nucleic acid stain into the solution with the help of pipette and pour the solution into the gel casting tray as I shown in the below picture. After pouring the gel, allow the gel to solidify for 30 minutes to 45 minutes. After solidification, add the loading die to the amplified PCR products to make it visible before loading. That is about 5 to 10 microliter of loading die you can add to the PCR product. And for loading purpose, first you have to load the DNA ladder for comparison purpose into the first well, followed by positive and negative controls and later PCR amplified products. Then place the gel casting tray into the electrophoresis tank and allow to run at 100 to 120 volts. Here we can volts we can vary at 80 to 120 volts. Then after completion of run, observe the gel in image analyzer and compare the amplified PCR products against the DNA ladder. That's all. Now you learned about the preparation of agarose gel for electrophoresis of PCR amplified products. In next video, let us learn about the RNA isolation from the leaf samples. Bye bye. Have a nice day.